Always be yourself, that is where you will find yourself. That is the key to the door for happiness and more. Always put your faith in your Lord, He will keep you safe. Don't ever feel no fear, He'll always be right here.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome, dear viewers from around the world joining us on our brand new program, Live Your Life. And I'm your host, Junaid Dar. Dear viewers, we've got a unique program here where we are talking about key concepts, ideas, verses from the Quran, or even the names and attributes of Allah Almighty. We're going to be looking today at the Basmalah. We're going to be looking at the name Allah. We're going to be looking at the name Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And how beautiful of a discussion is it that we talk about mercy? How desperate are we as mankind, not just Muslims, that we are lacking mercy towards one another? When we look around the world and we look at the wars, the famine, the struggles people are going through, what is it that one quality that is missing? It is mercy. So let us talk about that today, and let us begin by introducing our guest, and then we'll go straight into our discussion. Joining us in the studio to take this task forward, we have with us Dr. Saeed Al-Qadi, who carries a master's in Sharia and at the same time has a PhD in education. Sheikh, it gives me great pleasure and honor to have you here in the studio. I'd like to begin by saying Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah bless you, Sheikh Junaid. Jazakallah khair. It is also a pleasure. Barakallah feek.
Thank you very much. Sheikh, before we get into the details of the names and attributes of Allah, how important is it that we discuss Allah and His names and attributes?
Subhanallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. There is nothing that is more important nowadays than knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knowing His attributes, knowing His names. People are in need, in desperate needs, to know their Lord, to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to know their Creator, the one who brought them into existence, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because once we know Allah ta'ala more, we will love Him more.
SubhanAllah.
Once we know Allah ta'ala more, we will fear Him more. Once we know Allah ta'ala more, we will have reliance upon Him more, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once we know His names, His attributes, we will esteem Him as He has a right to be esteemed, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, it is very important for us to reflect upon the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon the Quran, and understand Allah's attributes and Allah's names. And in this chapter, Al-Fatiha, we have some of Allah's great names and exalted names, Allah and Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. In one verse only, we have three great names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty.
Sheikh, this reminds me of another verse inside the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that Allah is the one who has the most beautiful names. So call unto Him with these names. What does this mean?
Subhanallah. Well, Allah ta'ala is telling us that when you want to intercede, or you want to make a dua, you want to make a supplication, ask Allah Ta'ala using His names. Say, okay. Oh Allah Ta'ala, You are the most merciful, bestow Your mercy upon me. Oh Allah Ta'ala, You are the all-wise, give me this. Oh Allah Ta'ala, You are the all-giving, give me this. And I'll give you example. You know, Sulaiman alayhi salam, how he made his dua. He asked Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala a great dua, a great supplication. And he asked Allah Ta'ala, to give him a kingship that no one would be given after him or before him. He said, قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. Oh Allah, forgive me and give me a kingship that no one will be given after me. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ. Oh Allah, You are the all-giving. So he asked Allah Ta'ala using His name, the all-giving. So you see, when you make dua, when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His names, His exalted names, Al-Wahhab, Al-Kareem, Al-Rahman, Al-Rahim, all of those beautiful and exalted names of
okay,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Excellent. What a beautiful discussion to talk about Allah and His names and attributes. Sheikh, I want to look at some of the signs of Allah's mercy in His creation. Can you talk about that, please?
بإذن الله. Well, we talk about Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim.
Sure.
And the mercy of Allah, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the signs of Allah's mercy in His creation. Well, one of Allah's mercy is sending the prophets.
Subhanallah.
They were sent by Allah's Messenger, Subhanahu wa Taala. Allah Taala in the Quran said, "O Muhammad, we have not sent you to all of humanity except as a mercy." وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. O Muhammad, we have not sent you except as a mercy to all of humanity. So the messengers were sent as a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Allah ta'ala gave them, equipped them with the necessary manners to accept or to deal with the behavior of their followers in a very accommodating manner.
Okay.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is out of Allah's mercy. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ. It is because of Allah's mercy that you became lenient towards them, forgiving towards them, understanding with them. Subhanallah. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. And if you were harsh and hard-hearted, they would have scattered away from you, subhanAllah ta'ala. So Allah ta'ala instilled that mercy in the heart of his Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, and this mercy is from Allah, the Almighty, subhanahu wa ta'ala, for his creation as well. So sending the prophets is a sign of Allah's mercy. Revealing the book itself is a sign from Allah's mercy.
Okay.
Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, Ar-Rahman عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنِ. The most beneficent revealed the Quran or taught the Quran. So out of Allah's mercy, because of Allah's mercy, Allah Ta'ala revealed the book, subhanAllah.
Okay,
and that's why
nice.
We begin every chapter, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We begin by the name of Allah Ta'ala, the most beneficent and the most merciful. A sign of Allah's mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is legislation. You see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he spoke about the salah, he said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِالنَّاسِ لَرَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah will not cause your actions to go astray. Allah Ta'ala is the most merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is full of pity, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Subhanallah. Shaykh, you know, it's amazing with what you're saying that Allah's name, he is mercy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mercy. But yet we tend to find amongst some of our brothers and our sisters that when they start to learn Islam and start to become more practicing, they start to become more hard-hearted or difficult to approach. What advice would you give to all the believers that they're smiling and they're merciful to one another?
Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bestow his mercy upon his slave or his slaves who have mercy or who deal with mercy. In the sound hadith, the Nabi said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed bestows his mercy upon his merciful slaves.
Subhanallah.
إِنَّمَا يَرْحَمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الرَّحَمَةِ. Mercy is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mercy is an attribute that is attached to Allah, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'll give an example. When you see somebody who's like giving a khutbah.
Okay.
Can you give a khutbah once? He's not skillful. Do you call him khatib?
Okay.
You don't call him khatib, yes? But someone who's skillful in giving khutbah, you call him khatib because he is master in this matter. So fa'il in the Arabic, it means that this person or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the exalted, this quality is attached to him.
Okay.
Likewise, you call someone tawil, he's of high status.
He's always
tawil, isn't it? he's all tawil, that means this description is attached to him.
Okay.
You see? So when you say Rahim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim, this description is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This quality is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Okay.
And that's why we have in the sound hadith, Allah ta'ala says that he has prescribed, he has written on a book next to his throne that my mercy has preceded my anger.
Okay, excellent. Sheikh, after discussing Allah's mercy, I'm sure everybody and the viewers are desperate to know how can we obtain Allah's mercy? How can we become under the umbrella of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rahmah?
Jazakallah khair. One of the most important reasons to obtain Allah's mercy is to reflect upon the Quran.
Okay.
Is to listen to the Quran with an attentive heart. To listen to the Quran in a way that you want to understand it and you want to act upon it. Because you know the people of the hellfire, they won't regret anything in the hellfire more than them regretting that they never used to listen to the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. They would say in the hellfire,
وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعَقِلُ.
If you had only been listening or understanding,
مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ,
we wouldn't be amongst the inhabitants of the blazing fire. So if you want Allah's mercy, we need to listen to the Quran. We need to reflect upon the Quran.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا.
If the Quran is recited, then listen to it attentively.
Okay.
And reflect upon it. Why?
فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
So that he may have mercy upon you. SubhanAllah. So, reflection upon the Quran, pondering the Quran will bring Allah's mercy to us, inshallah ta'ala.
Okay.
Another reason of having Allah's mercy is to offer the obligations. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
SubhanAllah.
And another reason as well to have Allah's mercy in our life is to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala generally. And to obey the commandments of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
Okay.
Obey Allah and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and you will have mercy.
SubhanAllah.
Okay. Mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be as well obtained once you are as well merciful towards others.
Okay. SubhanAllah.
إِنَّمَا يَرْحَمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الرُّحَمَاء. I would like to as well to highlight an important point here as well. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, describing how the Quran can affect the hearts of the believers,
right,
and how it's important for us to listen to the Quran and reflect upon it with an attentive heart. SubhanAllah. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said in Surah Qaf,
وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ هُمْ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ بَطْشًا.
And how many generations before them we have destroyed, okay, who were mightier than them in power. SubhanAllah.
فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ.
And they used to occupy a lot of the parts of the land.
هَلْ مِن مَحِيصٍ.
Were they able to escape from our punishment?
SubhanAllah.
No, they were not. Then Allah Ta'ala said,
إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعَ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ.
Indeed, in this there is a reminder for anyone who has a heart, a living heart, a heart that he is utilizing, SubhanAllah, or أَلْقَى السَّمْعَ, or he is listening attentively. He wants to understand. He wants to reflect. And his heart is present. That's why you see someone behind the Imam. Imam is reciting, his heart feels fear. His heart is trembling out of fear because he's listening. But other people, subhanAllah ta'ala, they might be behind the Imam and they feel nothing. Why? Because their heart is absent.
Okay.
SubhanAllah. May Allah ta'ala grant us an attentive heart and enable us to acquire the actions that will bring Allah's mercy in our life.
Okay, Sheikh, that does bring us to the end of our episode today.
I
would like to thank you very much for coming to the studio and sharing with us your knowledge on the subject. Thank you very much.
Jazakumullah khair.
And conclude by saying Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much. Dear viewers, we've come to the end of this particular segment where we had a beautiful discussion about mercy. And really, in my idea, this is the one concept that mankind has truly lost. And a very simple reminder to all of us, the importance of mercy. Just look around the world, look in your countries, look in the Muslim world, look how much we are suffering, how much pain we are undergoing, how much people are being tortured, being killed, being blown to pieces. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put mercy into the hearts of everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give everybody a peaceful, a tranquil life that they all deserve. I'd like to thank you all for tuning in. And inshallah ta'ala, we will have an upcoming episode with another subject. So until that episode, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
always be yourself, that is where you will find yourself. That is the key to the door for happiness and more. Always put your faith in your Lord, He will keep you safe. Don't ever feel no fear, He'll always be right here. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. Always be yourself, that is where you will find yourself. That is the key to the door for happiness and more.